see you again. I hope you've been doing all right. Welcome back to another episode of ASMR and Beer, episode number nueve, number nine, where we'll be reviewing Innis and Gunn Rum Cask, oak aged beer. And then we're going to play a couple games of solitaire and munch on some pistachios for anyone who enjoys those particular sounds. So why don't we get started? Let me grab my glass, or first actually let me grab my trusty little keychain bottle opener thingy. Smell that from here. It's got a real strong. See if you can that's got a really strong yeast scent to it. You know what? I jumped right in here so fast, I didn't give a chance to read the bottle. Let's see. So it says, Innis and Gunn, oak aged like no other beer, handcrafted Scottish beer. Beer aged in rum barrels. It's got a 7.4% ABV. Wow. Let's see, it says carefully matured for 57 days prior to release. And it's got two signatures down here, approved for bottling, and then master brewer. And then on the back, since discovering the secrets and joys of maturing beer in oak barrels, we have been on a journey of further discovery, which has led us to some pretty incredible taste experiences. Rum cask is one of our firm favorites. A slow maturation using American oak and rum-infused oak has imparted this beer with a delicious warming character that is bursting with fruit and lively spiciness. And it says, imported by Innis and Gunn, USA, Manhasset, New York. Innis and Gunn, out of Edinburgh, a product of Scotland, contains barley malt. So let me just give this another a decent whiff here. That malty scent, but I'm also picking up that strong yeast. I want to say yeast. It's a real strong beer yeast. That's what I want to say. It's got, you can kind of see it here. It's got a very dark amber look to it. I hold up to the light. I can see through it, so it's not that dark. It's got some carbonation, and it does have a little slight sweet aroma to it. I want to say almost a floral, but not like flowery. It's probably the barley, I guess, or the malts. I don't know. I'm not expert on that, on the floral scents, so to speak. But yeah, it smells smells good. So let's give us a good swig. Sweetness to it, but definitely a strong alcohol, a flavor. I would say this is like a beer that's, well, it says rum cask, so aged in rum barrels. So yeah, I mean, you can definitely, to me at least, seems to have that rum characteristic to it. Not whiskey, but I guess rum. Yeah, it's a strong beer. It hits the roof of the mouth strong. It's got a little bit of a strong, bitter aftertaste. It's not, it's smooth, but it's a strong smooth. And maybe it's just me, because I've been sick earlier this week, but I feel fine now, and maybe it's just my taste buds and my olfactory kind of out of whack a little bit, but this is it's a good beer. I mean, for being a rum cask beer, it sure looks it, and it sure tastes it. That's got a strong aftertaste. I'm not sure if this was a beer. I'm not sure this would be a beer that I would drink too frequently. I'm not big on the this has a, you know, the more I drink of this, it definitely has a rum flavor to it. It's really strong, this beer, alcohol wise. I feel like I'm drinking rum almost, or whiskey. Not my favorite, definitely not one of my favorites. It's a good beer. I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to drink this one tonight. Whew. But we're gonna luckily I have some pistachios to aid me here, it's got a little bit of sweetness to it, but like I said, it's got that strong alcohol after effect. I guess not really after effect, but it's definitely a strong beer, and I don't mean beer flavored, but more strong alcohol. Alcohol-rich beer, if that makes sense. So, yeah, that's, you can, You can tell just by the label that it looks like a bottle of liquor almost. Didn't get a chance to show you close up, but yeah, this beer is no joke. I would say this beer is not, this is probably, I guess, this is probably, I guess, a good beer that they make in Scotland. Whew. Wow, they don't mess around Scotland, I'll tell you. That's a strong beer. So, I don't know where my chalkboard is, but good beer. Definitely not one that I'll be drinking on a regular basis just because I'm not big on whiskey and hard liquor. And this has those characteristics, and that's just not my thing any ever was really. When I was younger, I used to drink that stuff, vodka just to get drunk, and that was stupid, you know. I'm sure a lot of people have done that. We all live and learn. Yeah, this is probably gonna take me a while to nurse. So, if you've like to hear from you, if you've had this before and what you think, and what you think of the review. I think I gave it a decent review. I tried to describe it the best I could. And like I said, I think it's definitely more of a beer that wants to be a liquor, I guess, so to speak, or a beer that's it's been aged in rum barrels, so apparently it's absorbed some of that rum aspect. So whew. That's a strong beer. Not strong. It's more of the aftertaste. It's not liquor strong. But it's right there. It's borderline. You know, when you take a shot of whiskey, that's pretty strong. It's not that strong, but it's borderline. So that's an interesting beer. And definitely something I've never tasted before. Not something sure I'll frequent too much, but I had to try it based on someone's recommendation. So whoever you were that recommended that, thanks. I appreciate it. The next beer is gonna be the Leffe, Leffe. That's the next beer review. All right, so that's really it, just for that. So why don't we get going with the solitaire and have some pistachios and feel free to munch along. And enjoy your favorite beverage of choice with me. All right, let's go. This way because I can't do the normal flip, whatever you call it, the shuffle where you flip them together because it's gonna be too loud on the surface. This is like a this is not a table. This is just a see piece of foam board. I said, this is my top secret underground lab. It's the most quietest place. The most quietest. Like how I said that. The most quiet place. So we're just gonna shuffle like these. just playing solitaire. I'm also gonna teach you how to play solitaire for anyone that's never played before. So feel free to grab a deck. Don't worry about shuffling too much. And we're gonna deal. We're gonna lay out 7 cards. First cards face up.
Number on top here. So
upwards, but here you build upwards based on the lowest number from here. You'll see as we go along. It's not really that complicated. Let me go back to another swig here. Seven of spades. need a 10 of spades or 10 of clubs to go on top of there. We can move the 5 of clubs here over to the top of the 6 of hearts, revealing these underneath, which we flip over. Now we have a 2 of diamonds, which goes up top here, because we have our ace up top already. Flip underneath over. 4 of spades. We would need a 5 of clubs or 5 of... I'm sorry, 5 of hearts or 5 of diamonds to move, do anything with this. So, we have a lot of red cards. See? Not much to do here. Alright, next 3. Okay, 6 of spades. Can't really do anything with that. We would need a 7 of hearts or diamonds. Oh, wait, I missed this right here. The 7 right down here. I gotta make some room, so I'm gonna move these cards over here like this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We still have another space for another row to be built. Just bear with me. I'm still trying to work on the setup here. It's only the second time I've did a video of this kind of a card game, so I gotta work out the camera angles a little bit. Anyway, all right. So we got that built up. We would need a 3 of diamonds in order to move this up. We still don't have a ace of hearts. And that looks like all we can do for now. So let's do 1, 2, 3. 10 of clubs. Can't do anything with that. We would need a jack of diamonds or jack of hearts. 1, 2, 3. King. There we go. So that's our 7th space. 6, 7. So now we can put a queen of clubs or a queen of spades right there. 7 we can't do anything with. We would need an ace of spades or ace of clubs. Jack, perfect. Jack of spades on top of the queen of diamonds. Now, just bear with me here. We can move this pile all the way over here. Like that. See how we're building up? We're building the suit up so that eventually, once we get that 3 of diamonds, we can start moving these cards around and such. There's a queen of hearts. Okay, great. I don't remember which. I just forgot which way I was going here. Which was my waste pile. I just flipped them both over. So, oh well. We'll just go with that. Okay. I think we're done there. Jack. Can't do anything with that. 1, 2, 3. 3 diamonds. There we go. 3 diamonds up there. Move our 4 diamonds up there. Alright, now we have a 5 of clubs. Can't do anything with that. And as you can see, as you move cards up, cards over here can be moved to replace the ones that you moved up so that you can access the ones underneath. That's all part of the game too. Let's see. I can't move anything over here. Okay. All right, we're pretty much done there. 3, 7. Can't do anything with that. 1, 2. There we go. Queen of spades right here. All we need is a jack of diamonds or jack.
hearts or seven of diamonds available. Can't use that. One, two, three. Seven of clubs would need an eight of hearts or diamonds. One, two, three. Five of spades. And we would need a six of hearts or diamonds. And we really can't build up here yet either. So we're looking up there as well as we go through here. And looking down here to see what we can move up. Sometimes it's hard to keep track of everything, so... Two, three, seven of diamonds, nope. So once you go through the waste pile a couple times, and you're pretty much done, and this is pretty much it, this is what happens, you just get to a point where you've moved all the cards that you could, and there's not much else that you can do. So, well, I think that's going to do it for this episode. So why don't we play one more round? See if I can just shuffle these right here. That was horrible. Let's try that again. Thank you. whenever you uncover them. All right, let's take a look here. Okay, seven of hearts right on top of the ace of spades. Flip this card over. Five of diamonds, can't do anything with that. And that looks like we're done already. Oh, no, okay. So, one, two, three. Jack of diamonds. Would need a queen of spades or clubs. The four needs a five of clubs or spades. Eight. Sometimes you'll come across an instance where you have a free space and you might have two kings and on top of two different piles and you're not really sure which one to move over, and that's part of the game too. There could be a king in here as I go through in the waste pile that I might want to put on here that could help me more than this king could right now, but you never know, so we'll just take chances and move that one over. Now we have a four. Move this over to the red five. Red six. Can't do anything with that. Oh, yes, we can move the five of spades there. And we're doing okay so far. One, two, three, six. Yep, six of spades over here. Is that all? Spades right up top. Jack. Nope. Can't do anything with that. Five. Diamonds. Right here. Flip this card over. Three spades. Right up top. Now I got extra space for another king. So far, you can see we're building down our piles. I'm not really sure what the exact terminology is. One, two, three. Jack. Can't do anything with that. One, two. I'm sorry. Here we go. Four of spades. Right on top here. Moves this four of clubs down here to replace it. Let's just get this in order. Here we go. These cards are so slippery. All right. Okay. And let's see. And so, not bad so far. One, two. Oh, wait. There we go. Five of spades right on top. Diamonds. Nope. much at a dead end. Game over. We got a little further along than last time. But it's definitely can be challenging trying to complete all four suits. It's all a matter of where the cards get laid out underneath and in the waste pile and everything like that. So, all right, well, that's going to do it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed that. And like I said, the next ASMR and beer will probably involve